gonna need a seatbelt on.
I feel like I need my seatbelt on. Strapped in, ready for the show.
Okay. Okay, we have reassembled and the meeting is in, back in session. Are there other amendments or motions by the council? Mr. Manspeaker.
Motion to approve the budget as amended.
Second.
Okay, Mr. Manspeaker has moved, Mr. Harmon seconds to approve the budget as amended. That would be with all the amendments and the changes that have been made this evening. We have a motion before us. Mr. Schmidt.
Are we still at the 3.76 mil?
Okay. Yes, sir.
That would be correct. You have the
yes, sir.
3.76
yes,
mil of the increase.
Mm-hmm.
Discussion.
Mayor.
Mr. Harmon.
Thank you. Follow up to that, Mr. White, is that both the general fund and the debt service and special liability?
Mr. Mayor, yes, that is.
Thank you very much.
For discussion or questions? Anything before us?
Mm-hmm.
Seeing none, all those in favor of the budget as amended, approved, vote yes. Those opposed, vote no. I vote yes.
We have 4 yes, 6 no.
4 having voted yes, or 6 having voted no, the motion is defeated. Are there other amendments that we wish to consider? Mr. Harmon.
Thank you, Your Honor. I think I was on the prevailing side on the issue to regarding the court security. Council Member Manspeaker originally made the motion to add $114,412 for in-house security. I'd move to reconsider, if that'd be the appropriate motion, City Attorney.
Yes, it was, since it's within the same motion.
Okay, Mr. Harmon moved, Mr. Ortiz second, to reconsider the decision on the court outsourcing to of the contracted security. Is there discussion? Now, the motion, Mr. Sublett, if it passes, brings it back in front of us, then we have to take action to take action.
Correct. Yes, Mr. Mayor, you have to take the procedural vote first and the substance.
Okay, this is a procedural vote to bring it back on before us. Any discussion? All those in favor of bringing it back, vote yes. Those opposed, vote no. I vote yes.
We have 10 yes.
And having voted yes, it is back on the floor. Mr. Harmon, you may go.
I guess I would adopt by reference Mr. Council Member Manspeaker's motion. Perhaps if the clerk could
it's on this
could read that. It'd be whatever Council Member Manspeaker moved.
That I believe it was that it's a line item outsourced to contract security of $114,412. We're saying that we would put that back in the budget.
Yes.
I think that's what Mr. Manspeaker's motion was.
Yes.
Is that correct?
Yes.
Okay, Ms. DeLeese, plus seconds. Discussion? Mr. Manspeaker?
Yeah, I would just further emphasize the priority of safety within this building and why I think having a consistent crew of individuals versus the temporary service manage the safety of this building. I know Judge Miller said that we don't have the violent criminals that we have across the street, but I might differ from that in a little bit in that those folks that are typically charged with municipal crimes and appear before his bench are not necessarily, they're not here for felonies, they're not here for their gang conspiracy and everything else. The reality, though, is that a lot of those folks have parking tickets. A lot of those folks have small misdemeanor drug crimes that they're appearing for, and they might have 13 tattooed on their neck. They might be real legitimate gang members. So the safety of this courtroom is really my top priority here.
Thank you.
Mr. Mayor.
Mr. Campos.
There is access to this courtroom and to these chambers from the city council side. If anyone wanted to get on this side of the building, they could. And there's no guards that sit in front of TPAC will stop them.
Okay, other discussion? We're to vote on bringing that item back into the budget for the outsourcing of the contracted security. Those in favor of doing so, please vote yes. Those vote no, I vote yes. Sorry, is there a question?
Mm-hmm.
Yes, Ms. Ortiz.
Before the vote's announced, a yes vote would mean to bring it back, right? And a no
correct.
Vote is to leave it out?
Yes. Correct.
Thank
yes.
you.
All those in favor voting for bringing this back into the budget, vote yes. Those opposed, vote no. I vote yes.
We have six yes, Hiller, Compass, Ortiz, and Schwartz voting no.
Okay, six having voted yes, that item is back in the budget, $114,412. Are there other items?
I will make a motion to approve the budget.
As amended, Ms. Delisla moves to approve the budget with the amendment second tonight. Is there a second? Mr. Harmon seconds. I'm sorry. You want to give us the new figure?
Mr. Mayor, roughly 3.87 mils.
3.87 mil increase at this point. Okay, you've heard the motion. All those in favor vote yes. Opposed, vote no. I vote yes.
We have five yes and five no.
Five having voted no, the motion is defeated. Amendments or action the body wishes to take. Mr. Harmon.
Thank you, Your Honor. Councilmember Manspeaker had made a motion to add back in the $500,000 that had been previously directed to the city manager to cut. And I was on the prevailing side, so I'd make a motion to reconsider.
It's been moved to reconsider that $500,000 amount. Is there a second?
Second.
Okay, it's been moved in second. Again, this is a form of vote to bring it back on the floor for action. If you wish to do so, if you're voting to you wish to bring that back for action, vote yes. Those opposed, vote no. I vote yes.
We have three no.
Seven having voted yes, it is back on the floor. Mr. Harmon, do you want to proceed?
Councilmember Manspeaker made an eloquent statement as to why he wanted that money essentially taken out of the discretion of the city manager and put into the direction of the council. I voted against it because until I know where that those cuts are going to come from, I really can't support it. Otherwise, it just goes back in with no corollary where it's going to come out. So, I guess I would make a motion to add that back in, subject to this council making the determination tonight where we want that money to be cut. In other words, take it out of the discretion of the city manager, but yet we have to come up with $500,000 in cuts. Does that kind of make sense? I mean, I want to add it back in, but I also want to take it back out in specific directed cuts.
Or if you're saying that we will leave it as a $500,000 cut, but we want to have guidance and input into how that will
yes,
be made.
That's what I want.
All right. If that is a motion, reasonably stated, is it second? Are you seconding?
There hasn't been a second, so there's no discussion at this point.
Pardon me?
There hasn't been a second, so.
Oh, I'm sorry. I didn't hear the second. Of course. Discussion.
If the motion that I made, which I think the way it was just to put the money back in, I don't think the motion was clear that it was our job to make those cuts this evening. I mean, maybe it was. But wouldn't the, because he was on the prevailing side, wouldn't we need to vote on that specific motion again versus voting for a motion that says what he just stated? I am not trying to be disagreeable.
Because there was a motion to reconsider, so yes.
Mr. Harmon? Would you want to clarify what your response was? I'm not sure I understand.
Since it was a motion to reconsider, it passed. So now we need a vote on the clarification piece of that motion.
All right.
Because there was essentially a proviso, for lack of a better word, so we would need a vote on that piece of it at this point.
Well,
actually, I think Council Man Speaker's right.
Okay.
As I think about it, I think he's right. Because the motion to reconsider passed, I think then we go back to the original motion that Council Member Man Speaker made.
You're absolutely
so
correct.
My comments about the proviso are inappropriate.
Right. So we're back on the original motion. Councilman Mansfield.
So that motion Councilman Harmon made is ruled invalid. He was making one, and she seconded. So that's the that motion is off the floor.
Yes.
But we are back on looking at that at the $500,000 amount.
Yes.
Now, Mr. Mansfield.
So just to be clear, if we voted in favor of this motion, it would be only to bring back my motion on the table.
Yes.
And then at which point my colleague could attach an amendment that would have the proviso that he is interested in attaching.
He could attempt to make that amendment or substitute motion of whatever procedure he chose to follow at that point.
Thank you.
Okay. So we have no motion on the floor at this point. We're reconsidering the $500,000 amount.
Yeah. Yes, Mr. Mayor.
Does someone want to make a proviso to that? Actually, all right.
Can we vote on the motion?
Mr. Smith?
Reconsider, correct?
Yes, you voted on the motion to reconsider, so now you're back on Mr. Manspeaker's
back on the original motion. So now that motion is in search of a second?
No. Councilwoman Beale is the second of that, I believe. And so now if anybody would want to make a substitute or an amendment to Mr. Manspeaker's motion, this would be the point in time they would do that.
Okay, thank you.
So that would be speaking to the issue then that Mr. Harmon brought up about his original purpose in bringing us up. will get a proviso. Mr. Harmon?
Well, actually, I think it'd be cleaner just to vote on Councilmember Manspeaker's original motion. Then if that passes, then anybody on the council then could move where they want that $500,000 to come from. What do you think of that?
Yeah, procedurally. That would be.
That's cleaner, isn't it?
Yes, that would be.
Why don't we do that? Rather than trying to get caught up in amendments and divisions, we can just.
So we have the original motion back before us, which is to take out, remove the $500,000 city manager directed deductions. All right. All those in favor of that reduction, of taking that out of the budget, vote yes. Those opposed, vote no.
Adding
is that correct?
At no.
Kevin?
Mr. Mayor, if I might, the effect of the motion would be to increase general fund spending by $500,000.
That's correct.
Yes.
If you're, yes.
Add to the mill levy, increase general fund expenditures.
By $500,000. Okay. All those in favor vote yes, opposed vote no. I vote no.
We have 5 no.
And that's the fifth.
Approve the budget with the amendment. Is there a second? Mr. Harmon, second. All those in favor vote yes. Opposed vote no. I vote yes.
We have 5 yes.
Okay. 5 no. 5 vote no. The motion is defeated. City Manager.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. We had suggested in the previous budget document to the committee, and don't put that away too quick, not including the budget manager position, which we already took action on, but including the plan reviewer position that Miriam was just up talking about. We have a total of $265,000 that was brought forward. I certainly would ask for consideration of those budget items that were brought forward as potential cuts. And I want to be very clear, you did take action in voting against it at the end of the budget recommendation, but to Mr. Harmon's point, not feeling comfortable with assigning a $500,000 item to the city manager without identifying. We can identify $265,000 worth of items that has been brought forward and discussed. Understanding that you've already taken an action, Mr. Compost was going down the order of addressing all of those, and I don't want to speak for Miriam, she was up here, but we could get by without that plan of your position. We do have 3 electrical inspectors, and this that would take us down to 2. It could slow things down, but in conversation I have with her, and she's certainly, I'm not going to speak for her, but I think the department could get by with that, and I think we could consider all those other positions also to make progress. So that's $265,000, and it does not include the $91,000 for the budget manager, because I think we all agree that that is a vital position to go forward.
Okay. Mrs. Hiller?
One of the reasons that I did not I wasn't comfortable voting voting for the individual positions was because if we had the 500,000 block amount that we had delegated to you to decide, I didn't want us to itemize all of these on top of that. If what I'm hearing is you're thinking we could go a little higher, I would move to add $100,000 to that $500,000 for cuts, still deferring to the city manager to make the cuts.
It's been moved to increase that line item of the city manager directed reductions from 500 to 600,000. It's been moved and seconded. Is there discussion? Mr. Compo seconds the motion. Any discussion? All those in favor vote yes. Those opposed vote no. I vote no.
We have six no.
Six having voted no, the motion is defeated. Mrs. DeLisca?
City Manager, that means that you have found right now $265,000 in cuts that we have not approved yet, without counting the budget position. I'm just trying to clarify. So therefore, would it, and I'm just asking, would it be an adequate motion for elimination of the $500,000 so that then those 265 could be brought? I'm asking legal.
Motion would essentially be to change the $500,000 to $265,000.
Correct.
Yes.
I would like to make that motion.
Okay. It's been moved that we change the $500,000 to $265,000.
That are already designated.
That he has, that the city manager, the amount that he mentioned. I don't know that you're including in there those specific positions, or are you?
Yes, with
okay,
the specific
positions
that the city manager is recommending.
Is there a second? Mr. Harmon, seconds. All right. Do you understand what we're changing that line item of the 500,000 reduction to 265,000 based on the items that the city manager mentioned? Discussion, Mrs. Ortiz.
I guess I have a question, City Attorney. Some of these we've already voted on, right?
Yes.
So wouldn't we have to bring it back to the table with reconsideration? We can't just lump sum it all up. Some of these have already been voted on
right.
This evening.
It's a new motion, though, because before the motion was $500,000 at the discretion of the city manager. The new motion is $265,000, and those cuts being those identified by the city manager. So those are two separate motions. It's not a...
I disagree with that because some of the things that he identified we've already voted on. So I thought if we voted,
on them on the budget committee, but not.
No, I thought we voted on them.
We're just Marion's just now.
Oh,
just
for
the plan review.
You're correct, Deputy Mayor. I forgot about the.
Thank you.
Thank you. So the ruling is then that we can't.
It would be a motion to reconsider.
Motion to reconsider that. All right. So that motion be is null and void. Okay. Mrs. Ortiz.
Thank you. I just want to say that whatever we do, either the city manager is going to have to make the cuts or we're going to have to make the cuts. That's the bottom line. So whether we reconsider these votes and make the cuts to get out of here or sit here all night, that's the bottom line, but we need to do something. And I think the city manager said, you know, this department can handle it, whatever cuts we make, they're going to have to handle it. It doesn't matter where they come from. But we've got to do something, or we're going to have to leave it at his discretion to do it.
Mr. Harmon?
Mm-hmm. you, Your Honor. So, City Attorney, what the reason that Councilwoman De La Isa's motion cannot be considered was because we had already taken action on the elimination of that planner position?
Yeah.
Is that correct?
Yeah. Yes.
I was holding
yes,
that. Okay. Because I was on the losing side. No, I was not on the prevailing side, so I can't move for reconsideration. Because I voted yes, and it failed.
Yep.
So, okay.
Ms. De La Isa?
Of that particular?
Yep.
Okay. And she can make that motion?
To reconsider.
To reconsider.
Okay.
Mr. Harmon seconds. No. Can you describe for us what we are reconsidering?
For the planner.
Is it a reconsideration for the planning position, or is it a reconsideration for $500,000?
The motion to reconsider to eliminate the plan review position, the amount of $69,394.
Okay, we have a motion to reconsider the action taken on the planning position. Originally, there was a motion to eliminate that position. It was defeated. So we're reconsidering that the action taken to defeat or to eliminate that position. So a vote to reconsider would be to merely to bring it back on the floor and to take a new vote. All those in favor vote yes. Those opposed vote no. I vote yes.
We have 7 yes, 3 no.
I think I voted yes.
Oh, 8 yes.
8
you were.
Yes.
I'm sorry, 8 yes.
Voted yes.
Two no.
So the motion is back on the floor. And we consider the planning position. Ms. Hiller?
A question for the city manager.
Okay.
Did I understand you correctly earlier to say that if we voted to eliminate any or all of these itemized positions in addition to the $500,000 that you have, you think we could handle that?
I did not say that.
I mean, I was voting against the individual ones in part because we'd already given you the blanket.
Your Honor, if I could, I believe that the $500,000 is no longer being considered. And I believe that's off the table.
No.
It's not?
And we haven't removed it yet,
okay.
So it's still in there.
All right. What I was suggesting is that because of the statements made by Mr. Manspeaker and Mr. Harmon that they wanted to identify what those cuts would be, I identified that in our budget process we had identified, as Mr. White has told me, there's a remaining $265,000 in cuts that we identified that does not include the $91,000 for the budget position, that if action was taken on those, that would get us closer to that $500,000 figure. That still leaves $235,000 that we would need to address.
And that 265 does include the planning position.
It does.
And so that's we have before us to reconsider our decision on the planning position. So, right, well, Mr. Harmon.
Okay, so the vote to reconsider elimination of that planner position passed, so that motion is back before the council.
Yes, we're back on that original motion.
So if it fails, then I'm trying to figure out procedurally whether a vote for or against means with respect to what Councilwoman De La Isa was trying to accomplish with the 200 some odd thousand cuts. So we want to.
The original motion was to
reconsider the elimination of the plan review position in the amount of $69,394. So.
And that failed?
Yes.
The original motion failed?
Yes.
So.
The reconsideration would be to vote yes would mean the elimination of the position. That's the way I interpret it.
And if we vote.
A vote yes would be to eliminate the position.
Yes. So.
We're voting again on the same motion.
Yes.
We're voting to eliminate the position.
Well, but.
Mr. Harmon?
And maybe I'm not articulating my concern, but the city manager said, referenced the 200 and some odd thousand in cuts, this planner position was among them.
Mm-hmm.
Is that correct?
Correct.
Mm-hmm.
So we're reconsidering. So I guess if we want the city manager to eliminate it, we're going to have to defeat this motion. Is that right?
I see it differently, but I will.
If you vote yes, you eliminate the position.
Well,
and that was one of the recommended cuts that was brought forth by the city manager.
Mr. Schmidt?
A yes vote would eliminate that position outside of the $500,000 that's still in the budget. Mm-hmm. City manager directed
yes,
cuts.
Yes, that's correct. Mm-hmm.
So if we vote yes, then we cannot do the same to Michelle's earlier, or Councilwoman De La Isla's.
So what you're saying really, you say is a no vote is to bring about what the direction that we think Councilwoman De La Isla is going. All right, is everyone clear? We are voting the motion is to eliminate this planning position. A vote yes would eliminate it. A vote no would not eliminate it. Is that correctly stated?
Yes, that's correct.
And just to reiterate what Councilman Schmidt said, a vote yes at this juncture would eliminate it on top of the $500,000, therefore, to take this would no longer be available for the city manager. Okay.
Okay, all those in favor, vote yes. Those opposed, vote no. I vote yes.
We have six yes. Mr. Compton, you're a yes. Okay, we have six yes.
We have six. Having voted yes, the motion is approved, or the amendment is approved, to eliminate this position. And now we can have a motion that we had earlier that was void then.
So therefore, that means that now I can make a motion to amend the $500,000 request to $194,000.
And that leaves the other positions that can also be eliminated at the discretion of the city manager. No.
No,
we're changing the $500,000 down to
$194,000.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Specific. Of course, that specific amount. Is there a second? Is there a second? Mr. Schmidt seconds. So the motion is to change the $500,000, the city manager directed reductions to, I believe it's
$194,000 in the positions that the city manager mentioned that he's a clown.
Okay. Ms. Everhart?
I guess just to clarify, if I could ask the city manager to list those out again so that we all know which ones are still going to be eliminated by this motion.
Okay, I'm going to ask Mr. White to walk through those.
Mr. Mayor, in addition to the plan review inspector the council just took action on, there would be the elimination of one engineering tech one position in Public Works, $47,000. That is a construction inspector. A second engineering tech one position, which is a survey crew member, $45,000. One FTE out of finance, which would be either payroll or purchasing, for $40,000. And an HR specialist three position in human resources for about $64,000.
Okay. Yes, Ms. Everhart?
Well, that's what I was why I asked. Thank you for repeating those. I can't support this because what I had originally said some time ago, in my district, the construction inspector was so important. I got more calls and complaints with the Southeast 37th Street project because people couldn't even get in their driveways, and the delay was caused by the fact that we had no available construction inspectors to go out, so the contractors, all that stuff just sat. And I don't know if any of you hear complaints from people on road projects for how come nobody's working, but I got numerous calls on that issue, and so I can't support this with the construction inspector being included.
Mrs. Ortiz?
I'd like to make a friendly amendment to consider each one of those one by one.
Okay. It's been moved to a friendly amendment that each of these would be considered on an individual basis. Discussion? Mr. Schmidt?
I'm not sure how that's an amendment. I mean, that would be a procedure, wouldn't it?
So the question was asked, is that an appropriate amendment, is because it's really dealing, changing the tenor of the motion.
Yeah, it's dividing the question into
separation. I don't.
Yeah.
I think it would be difficult to do that, and I would rule it'd be out of order.
I challenge that because all we're doing is voting on each one of them one at a time, so we can get somewhere.
Well,
so I would challenge that.
The chair's made a ruling, and the council can vote on the chair.
Yeah, it's, if you want to overrule, there could be a vote.
Well, I overrule because I think it can be done, and that way we could move on and get a process done.
Okay. So it's
the vote is whether or not to overrule the decision of the chair.
Just a vote by the council, whether you support the ruling of the chair or not.
Yeah. And the ruling of the chair was that it was an improper amendment to the motion.
All those in favor, support of the ruling of the chair, vote yes. Those opposed, vote no.
We have five yes. Compass, Ortiz, Schwartz, and Harmon voting no.
Mrs. Hiller?
Well, I do think, given where we are, that people who are comfortable with this can vote it up or down. If it doesn't pass, people could come back and do these one at a time if they choose, correct?
Yeah. We have a motion before us. With an amount, with these positions that were listed, in lieu of the $500,000 amount. Is there a question? All those in favor vote yes. Opposed vote no. I'm sorry, point of order.
This would effectively increase our mill levy, correct?
Yes.
Yes.
It would, because we're going from 500 down to
exactly. I can't
170 something. All right. All those in favor of the motion vote yes. Opposed vote no. I vote no.
We have nine no, one voting yes.
Okay, Mrs. Ortiz.
Thank you. Give me those, Jeff, because I forgot what they were. So give them here so I can make sure you have yours right there.
Yes.
We'll vote on these one at a time.
Mr. Mayor, we have one engineering tech position in Public Works, which is a construction inspector. A second engineering tech position.
No, let's do one at a time.
Oh,
we're going to do one at a time. So what's the first one?
It's an engineering technician position in public works that is a construction inspector. The dollar amount is $47,000.
So moved. Make that motion. So moved.
Okay, it's been moved to eliminate that position. Mr. Smith?
Haven't these all already been considered?
In committee, but they were considered in the budget committee.
But not in the council.
So we can vote on them again. So moved and seconded to eliminate that position. Discussion. All those in favor vote yes. Opposed, vote no.
Your vote, Mayor?
I vote yes.
We have 4 yes, 6 no.
Thank you. Mr. Mayor, if I may?
Yeah.
Number 2.
Mr. Mayor, second position is an engineering tech 1 position and also in public works. This is a survey crew member.
So moved.
I'm moved in second to eliminate that position. All those in favor vote yes. Opposed, vote no. I'm sorry. Point, Mr. Taylor.
Could we have a description of that position? It went down 6-0-6 last time. So if we could just have a description of what that person does.
Mr. City Manager.
Thank you. Mr. Mayor, I'd like to ask Mr. Whitaker, Public Works Director, to come forward.
Mr. Mayor and Council, this position is part of the survey crew, and so it is a 3-man crew that goes out and does surveying. Could we reduce this? Yes. Because there is newer technology out there that maybe you don't need a 3-man crew.
Thank you. Discussion? All those in favor of eliminating that position vote yes. Opposed, vote no. I vote yes.
We have 9 yes.
9 having voted yes, it is, the amendment is passed. You have another one, Mr.
Was
White?
There one more, Mr. Jeff? Mr. White? Two more.
Mr. Mayor, the next item is the elimination of 1 FTE in purchasing or payroll. So this would be out of the finance department. In either case, this would be a reduction in force of 1 FTE. Our hope is through the implementation of the IntelliTime time and attendance software that we'll get to the point where through efficiencies we could reduce 1 FTE. I can't tell you whether that will be in 2013 or 2014. If it's not in 2013, then we'd eliminate the position in purchasing.
So moved.
Second. Moving second to eliminate this position. Is there discussion? If not, all those in favor of eliminating the position vote yes. Those opposed vote no. I vote no.
We have 6 yes, 4 no.
6 having voted yes. The amendment is approved.
Mr. Mayor?
There is another one.
Mr. White?
Mr. Mayor, the last item on the list is the elimination of an HR specialist 3 position. There is an incumbent in that position would result in a reduction in force of 1 FTE.
So moved.
Second, Mr. Mayor.
Moved and seconded to eliminate this position in human resources. There is discussion. Mr. Taylor?
Just briefly, I supported this at the committee level. Because we still have the $500,000 on the table for the city manager's cuts, I am not going to support that this time. Thank you.
Just
okay. I'm sorry.
Sorry, Mr. Mayor. Thank you. I just wanted to clarify for those on the council and definitely those at home and sitting in the audience, we've gone through these several times, and that our department heads can live with these cuts. This is what they've provided for us to cut. Thank you, Mr. Mayor.
Okay. Any discussion? All those in favor of the amendment vote yes. Those opposed vote no. I vote yes.
We have 5 yes and 5 no.
5 having voted no, the amendment is defeated. Mrs. Ortiz?
Is that all, Jeff?
Yes, ma'am.
Where are we at, Jeff?
$3.72 mils roughly in total, including both funds.
Okay. Mr. Man Speaker?
What does 3.72 mils equate to in actual dollars?
$3.72
roughly $3.7 million.
Okay. The increase. Mrs. Del Isla?
Mr. White, could you give us an update how much it would be to add in the $500,000 in mills?
I'm sorry.
If the $500,000 were to be added at this point, how much would that equate in mills?
Roughly one half of one mill.
Okay, now just to clear, it is in there right now.
No, but I'm talking about if it's added back, then how much would that mill be?
How much will we increase?
Exactly, how much would it increase?
We're at 3.72 now, it would be roughly 4.22.
Wait a minute, say that again, it's 500,000.
Right, which is roughly one half of one mill. So we would go from 3.72
okay.
to 4.22.
Okay.
Roughly.
Understood.
Move to approve the budget.
Motion to approve the budget.
As amended?
As amended.
Is there a second?
Second.
Okay. And again, we are at what level, Jeff? What is the budget, the mill levy increase at this point?
The estimated mill levy increase is 3.72 mils.
3.72 mils. Okay. They have this before us. All those in favor of the budget? With amendments at that level, vote yes. Opposed, vote no. I vote yes.
We have 7 nays.
Okay, we have a...
I'm here.
So we have a direction we're going. I suggest I will call an adjournment. Was there a motion, Mr. Man Speaker?
I've got another motion. I'm shooting from the hip a little bit here, so if I can't do it, just tell me I can't do it. But I would make the motion that we increase all building permit fees by 15%, which would generate approximately out of $991,631 in building permit fees in 2012, that would be equivalent of $148,744 generated.
Okay, it's been moved, and Mr. Compo seconds, correct? Did you second?
No, I'll resend.
I'm sorry. Motion has been made. Is there a second to increase the building fees? Mr. Harmon seconds. Now, do you want to speak any more to that?
Yeah. I had a meeting several months back with the Public Works Department, and one of the issues that was expressed to me was that building permit fees hadn't changed in a significant amount of time, and there are oftentimes, though they operate in the flush, because of permit and licensing fees, but there are times that the fee structure doesn't cover the actual staff cost of administering the permit. So in my mind, a basic increase of 15% across the board, it doesn't impact anybody too much. For somebody who, say, wanted to build a 3,000 square foot home, it'd be $99 more on their building permit fee. Now, if you're gonna build a $3,000 square foot home, costing probably $200,000 in this market, $99 isn't a big punch in the gut on that one. Room additions, the average room additions, $275 right now, 751 to 1,000 square feet. You're looking at $32, $33 added to that $275 cost. I really don't think these numbers are astronomical.
Okay. Is there a discussion, Ms. Taylor?
Could we ask Mrs. Berkey to come up and react to that? I know that there was a discussion of $2 increases to fees in the future. I also recall us spending some months dealing with our building permit fees not too long ago and capping them for big developments because we didn't want to discourage development.
But ask Mr. Whitaker or
whoever.
Ms. Berkey, whoever would be, wants to address sort of a new topic. So we can have a team approach. So they have not discussed this ahead of time, so it'll be very to us.
Yeah, I think there's a couple issues. One would be if you wanted to simply increase the building permit fees, which have not been adjusted for a good number of years. The other thing is, for example, a trade permit for a residential, say you're doing an electrical service upgrade, the trade permit is $53. If you're doing a commercial trade permit, it's $103 currently. So I guess the question is, and those have been raised more recently, but the question is, do you want it all-encompassing for licenses, trade permits, building permits, or is this simply just building permits? Or do you want to, I mean, do you want us to bring back some numbers too?
My motion on the floor would only apply to building permits.
Okay.
Mr. Mayor?
Okay, do you have anything else just on building permits? You know, the motion is just on that. And when
right.
were they last changed, or do you remember offhand?
Oh, I think it's been over, I'm sure it's been over 10 years.
Okay.
And my request,
okay, Ms. Hiller,
had been to have you react a bit then, now that you've explained it, to whether you, how you think that would go over, whether it's manageable.
Well, I think, again, in terms of development, when fees go up, obviously there's a little bit of pushback. So, you know, in terms of my immediate response, I would expect some pushback, but again, they've not been raised for quite some time in terms of the building permit fees.
Are there other questions for our public works people? Did you have, Mr. Koppels, did you have a comment?
I don't have any questions. I'm sorry.
I think that's okay. All the questions, but stay close.
Okay.
Ms. Hiller?
Just another reaction. I think it's a great idea. I just worry about making a decision that quickly. We have had tremendous collaboration with the home builders and the associate general contractors as we've done various code changes, and that's been really positive for us. And so it might be that it would go just fine. It just is sudden.
And you had an amount. You stated an amount that would, but should we?
15% across the board, just looking at building permits, not looking at the other fees that you discussed. That's what would generate $148,000.
Okay, $148,000.
Mr. Mayor?
Yeah, I'm sorry. I thought you had your.
I was going to ask him to explain the numbers, but he just did.
Okay, thank you. Mr. Koppels?
I don't know if it's palatable, but if we're going to increase fees, and this is something that I had mentioned, how about 15% across the board?
That's what I said.
Not only to permits or licensing, but for cereal malt.
Well, I think that would have to be a different, that would be separate motion.
Could we just do it blanket, all fees for the city?
City manager?
Yeah. Mayor, thank you very much. I have to tell you, I'm getting increasingly uncomfortable. We had a motion that was included in the budget of $500,000, and you're talking about taking, from a professional management perspective, working over a period of time with professional staff, evaluating the impacts of all of these decisions, and because we're uncomfortable with that, we're now sitting here making up things on the fly that we have we have really no idea as to what the impact's going to be on the organization. And I respect this body tremendously, and we have a very good working relationship, but we're making this very difficult. We have a very good professional staff. We're putting the team together, and I believe that by us working through our process, we will come back with a much better solution that will have a much longer-term positive impact on the city than us sitting here this evening trying to figure out how to come up with $500,000. I am your city manager. I'm committed to following the direction that you provide, but I think that I can do a better job at this given the right time and the right process.
Mr. Mayor, I think that's excellent advice. I would encourage anyone who is in support of that $500,000 cut to vote yes for the budget, and then we can all go home.
We do have a motion on the floor to raise the building permits 15%, to raise approximately $170,000. Mr. White?
Mr. Mayor, if I might clarify, we have a budgeted line item in the general fund for development services permits generally, which includes not only the building permits being referenced, but other permits as well. That is in the budget at $650,000 for 2014 as an estimate. Those numbers were substantially higher in 2012, I recognize. We're seeing a downward trend in those permit fees in 2013. So from a costing perspective, it's very hard to score, as the city manager indicated, what the value of that revenue increase might be, but I think $140,000 is too high.
Okay, we've heard those comments. Mrs. Everhart.
Well, there's been a lot said about whether it's appropriate to just pick and choose things like this, and I respect everybody's opinion on that, but if they haven't been raised in 10 years, if I could ask if you were going to suggest a raise, what would you suggest? I mean, 10 years is a long time not to have increased these permit fees, building permit fees.
A little hesitant I don't know what the correct percentage would be, to be quite honest.
Okay, it is putting you on the spot, Mr. City Manager.
Thank you, Mayor. Mr. Mayor, the process would be that we would benchmark ourselves against other communities. We would take a look at the best practices. We would make a determination as to what the impact of an increase in fee would be upon our business. Sometimes when you increase the fee, you may have the unintended consequences of driving business somewhere else, and you ultimately are in worse shape than you were. And that's why I think it's absolutely vital that we do this as part of a professionally managed process. And I think that's the reason that we have a professional staff here to specifically carry out these policies.
Yes, Mr. Everhart.
Then in follow-up, is staff looking at this? Is this something that at some point in time you were going to look at and propose?
Mayor and Councilmember Everhart, there are a lot of things that we need to look at. We very, very fortunate that we attracted Mr. Whitaker to join us as the Public Works Director. We're taking a look at ways that we can cut costs and we can raise revenues. Did we specifically have this on the radar? Maybe we didn't, but we certainly would, just like there's a lot of things that we need to do. This has been the first year kind of putting the team together, getting the holes filled in the boat. And I think we're floating now, and the idea is to continue to improve the professional operations. So it's a very valid question. I don't want to say it was on page two of my list, but it's certainly something that we need to continue to look at ways that we can increase revenues for the city, but in a way that is positive. So
thank you.
Okay, we have a motion on the floor, Mr. Manspeaker.
Technically, that way would be positive.
Is there other discussion on the motion? A motion to increase the building permits by 15%, bringing in about $170,000. All those in favor vote yes, opposed vote no. I vote no.
We have five yes and five no.
Five having voted no, the motion is defeated. I will call a 10-minute recess.
you got in there, Lane?
What you got in there?
You accept?
He's just wishing he thought ahead.
The city has an ordinance that if meetings go after 10 o'clock or 10 p.m., we have to have a motion to extend the meeting. Such a motion would be in order. Mrs. Ortiz moves that we extend our time after 10 o'clock with no specific time that we will be adjourning. Is there any discussion? All those in favor vote yes. Opposed vote no.
Nine, yes.
Nine, having voted yes, the meeting time is extended. There are various possibilities that we can look at. We need to have six votes. As we said at the beginning, we have to come together in a consensus, and none of us will get the budget that we want. We have to have some compromise. We have to agree to work on this together. So those who feel strongly about the budget, or if there's some reason that they feel something could be addressed or changed in order to get more votes, I wish that we could make those motions so that we can start addressing them in that manner. Mrs. De Lisa.
I move that we remove the $500,000 in cuts from the budget.
Okay, it's been moved to remove the city manager directed reductions to $500,000. Is there a second? Seconded by Mr. Van Speaker, who is enjoying his cupcake.
Mid cupcake.
Is there discussion? All right. Senator Fox. So those vote in favor of the taking out of the budget the $500,000 reduction, or it's putting $500,000 into the budget. Those in favor of that vote yes. Opposed vote no.
Your vote, Mayor.
Okay, I'll make sure we have it correct.
Wait a minute. Wait a minute. A yes vote would leave it in. A no vote would take it out.
Other way around. A yes vote.
Can I clear the board, please?
All right. Thank all you. Those in favor of the motion, which is to remove the $500,000 cut.
So it's in?
Vote yes means that we are increasing the budget by $500,000. I vote yes.
We have five yes and five no.
Having voted no, the motion is defeated. Thank you for your effort. Forward to another amendment. Mr. Schmidt.
I would make a motion to restore the $30,664 that was cut from youth and social services funding.
Okay. The motion is to restore this amount to the social, to the fund, that's the common with the grants.
To the grant funding for youth and social services, which was cut by 10% or 15%.
All right.
15.
And that amount was approximately?
The amount listed here was $30,664.
$30,000 approximately. And Mrs. Everhart seconds. So this would be a motion to increase the budget by this amount. By 30,000 approximately. Okay. Any discussion? Any questions? All those in favor vote yes. Opposed vote no. six voting yes, the amendment is approved.
I would make a motion to adopt the budget as amended.
And moved to adopt the budget as amended. Is there a second? Mr. Harmon, second. All those in favor vote yes. Opposed, vote no. I vote yes.
We have six. Mr. Harmon? Are you?
You can't have it both ways. Yes.
Darn.
But
that means it didn't pass.
It didn't pass.
I can clear the board and come back again.
Maybe let's re-vote. Okay, this is a motion to adopt the budget as amended. All those in favor vote yes. Opposed, vote no.
Yes, Mayor.
I vote yes. Five.
We have five yes and five no.
Five having voted no, the motion is defeated. Okay. Thank you to those who voted yes. So, for those who voted no, if you would like to make a motion to help us move along. We appreciate it, Mr. Campos.
I'm sorry, where do we stand on the permits? Did you vote that down?
We voted that down. Yes, that was defeated.
I'd like to move to reconsider 15% increases to the fees.
We move to reconsider the vote on the 15% increase in fees. A second. It dies for lack of a second. What is the mill levy at increase at this point? Mr. White.
Mr. Mayor, 3.75 mills.
3.75 mills. The general feeling that the mill levy is too high, is that the direction that that we should be looking at in order to get six votes? We want to discuss this in general, or is there something that specifically we should look at that we should be considering?
I would note that the vote totals have gone up when the budget has gone up and have gone down when the budget has gone down. So I think it behooves people voting against the budget to
you're having a conversation with three, you need to have it with all of us. And it looks like you and Denise and Michelle are having a conversation. So it needs to be, if it's more than one, if it's more than two, it needs to be on the table.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Along those lines, if what we need to do is just have some open discussion for a few minutes for people to throw out some ideas, I'm certainly open to that. Especially the people that aren't in favor of the budget. Mr. White?
Yes, ma'am.
Could you please give us a total of when we talked about the concern with the $500,000, we were trying to see if we could amend motions. What was the total amount that we ended up reducing out of those individual votes?
$154,000.
Mr. Mayor?
Yes, Mr. Topeka.
I'd like to move page 72. Make a motion to X out $20,134 out of education and travel from the Informational Technology Department. Technology Department, pardon me. You said you wanted to set a target?
Yeah, I was just saying, I'm just making sure that I have, I'm on page 72, and this is under what, which line item is it again?
Pardon me? Under miscellaneous 52,300, okay. Seems to be a
All right.
consistent number for both throughout the entire budget.
Okay, so move to eliminate the $20,481 line item 52,300 education travel under miscellaneous in the information technology department.
Point of order 23.
I'm sorry, did I state it wrong?
It's okay.
I read the wrong year. 20,134, correct, for the 2014 budget?
Yes, pardon me.
Okay, and it's been seconded by Mrs. Ortiz. Mr. Schmidt?
This is, I think, in a similar vein to outsourcing the security in the courthouse. This is a move that will cost us in the long run. We're implementing several new systems, technology systems. The thing that anybody that works in technology realizes is that technology is increasing at a faster rate than it ever has before. $20,000 on training is essential.
This is not training. This is education.
Education is training. $20,000 spent on education will probably result in savings well in excess of that. As I think all the there's several members on here who work in IT would agree, we can't expect our staff to implement new technologies and to create efficiencies and then take away the tools from them that allow those things to happen. So I will not support this.
Is there other discussion?
Mr. Mayor,
if
I might, just a reminder that IT charges its services out to every city department, so only a share of this will impact the general fund and thus the property tax levy.
Okay, I think that understood what the point was. discussion? If not, all those in favor of the reduction of that $20,134 vote yes. Opposed, vote no. I vote no.
Thank you, Your Honor. My notes reflect that $500,000 in city manager directed cuts is still in the budget. Is that correct?
Yes.
Okay. And we've already taken out $154,000 in cuts that could have been made with that.
Those were the positions that were that we voted to eliminate, correct?
So I would add back the difference between $500,000 and $154,000, which is $346,000.
Okay. So the motion is to replace the $500,000 with $346,000.
Correct.
So we're reducing that line item from 500 to 346. I'm just saying that I'm okay. If this isn't correct.
Say that again.
All right. What you want to state your motion?
Well, as of right now, it is in the budget that we reduce expenditures by $500,000 by asking the city manager to make cuts of $500,000.
Correct.
Okay. In discussions, the city manager indicated that one of these areas he would look at, we have, through subsequent votes, already eliminated those positions. Mm-hmm. Those position totals $154,000. So what I'm proposing is that we add back to the budget, in other words, we take out the money that we had asked the city manager to cut, and we just add back in $346,000. And if we want to cut it subsequently, we can, but this is just to add that back in. Does that make sense, Jeff?
Mr. Mayor, my understanding is this would increase the budget, not yes. $500,000 as we've had a couple discussions about, but $346,000.
Right.
Okay. Is there a second? All right. Elise with seconds. Now, do we understand we're changing the 500 to 346?
Well,
no.
No.
We're adding the 346 back to general fund expenditures. We're adding.
Okay. That's what I'm meaning to say, but I'm not saying. Mrs. Everhart.
Perhaps it would be better if what you would tell us, Jeff, if I may, is what then is the discretionary cut that the city manager is going to make? What's the amount of the cut rather than $500,000?
My understanding is, well,
there is none. Zero. Mm.
In order to accomplish that goal, then we'd need to eliminate the whole $500,000.
Yeah.
No. That's where I was.
Yeah, that was my. You see what we're saying? We increased the 500, but we have eliminated 156 over here.
Right. So there's.
So we still have the 500 up here.
So what's on the table is 600 and. $54,000 in total cuts between the positions and the $500,000 manager discretionary cuts. So your motion would effectively restore half of that, more or less, to the budget. So that would leave the $157,000 in cuts plus a portion of the $500,000 that would be left.
I think think we're talking about the same thing, but it's...
I'm not sure we are.
Okay, maybe we aren't.
I'm totally confused.
If your intention is to end the day with just those $154,000 in cuts, then your motion, we need to add back the entire $500,000. That would leave, between those two actions, a net reduction in the budget of $154,000. You tracking now?
Well, we can try it again, but so the motion would be to add back the $500,000, which we've considered three times now, and all three times have rejected.
It depends on what the intention of your motion is. The effect of the motion that you made would be to not only have the $154,000 in specific cuts, but would leave roughly the same amount in manager-directed cuts in the budget.
But what I'm wanting to do is reduce the amount of city manager directed cuts.
Yes.
That's
and that's what I heard you say.
So how do I do that?
By how much?
Well, I mean, we've already taken out 154, so that's why I came up with this 346,000. Because that's how much of the original 500,000 is left.
So
we've got the 500,000 cut in right now, and we've eliminated positions for 150. So you're saying we only give the rest of this to the city manager to make cuts, which is 350. That's what I hear you saying.
The motion would be to reduce the 500,000.
So, yeah, the motion would be to reduce the 500 to 350 or something.
I thought that's what I said.
Well, whatever. We're getting there.
Nathan
now
tells me I'm transposing the numbers. But, I mean, seriously, help me out here. I think you understand what I'm trying to get at. I'm just not articulating it.
What he's trying to say is to, I think this is what he's trying to say, is to make a motion to amend the $500,000 in city manager-directed reductions to an amount of $346,000 in city manager reductions, which would reflect the elimination of 154,000 that we accomplished earlier.
Let's try that.
Yes.
Thank you.
That's where I thought we started. Is there a second?
Was that my motion?
Okay,
or
we can do Mr. Schmidt's motion.
Okay.
Is there a second?
Yeah.
I'll vote for it, so there'll be at least three. Okay. You understand that motion, Ms. Hiller?
A question for Mr. White. Where would that leave us if we did that? Where would we be at mill levy wise?
3.9.
We have a motion to make that adjustment in the $500,000 city manager directed reductions. Discussion. All those in favor vote yes. Those opposed vote no. I vote yes.
We have 7 yes. Campos, Ortiz, and Schwartz.
Cool. Shelly.
Motion to approve the budget as amended.
Motion to approve the budget as amended with these changes. Is there a second? Mr. Schmidt votes, or seconds. Any discussion? All those in favor vote yes. Those opposed vote no. I vote yes.
Since I was on the prevailing side, motion to reconsider.
Mr. Harmon moves to reconsider that vote. Is there a second? It's been moved and seconded. All those vote to this is just the provisional, voting to reconsider. Those in favor vote yes, opposed vote no, I vote yes. I'm sorry. Vote again. I vote yes.
We have 8-9 yes.
9 having voted yes. We are to reconsider the previous vote. So the motion will be made. We vote again on that motion. All those in favor of the budget with amendments, vote yes. Opposed, vote no. I vote yes.
We have 6 yes.
We have adopted the budget. Thank you for your vote. We have about 5 other items on the agenda. The next item is C, Home Rule Ordinance, General Obligation Bond. If the clerk would read, please.
C is a Home Rule Ordinance introduced by City Manager Jim Coulson, authorizing and providing for the public sale of
chambers. I'm sorry. Point of order.
Clear the chambers.
Okay, well, we're not clear, but ask.
That's illegal.
If you'd please exit, if you want to have discussion so that we can go on with the meeting, please. Thank you. If the clerk will read the item C, Home Rule Ordinance.
C is a Home Rule Ordinance introduced by City Manager Jim Coulson, authorizing and providing for the public sale and issuance of taxable general obligation bonds of the City of Topeka, Kansas. Fund certain employee separation benefit costs of the city for eligible employees of the city and pay the cost of issuing such bonds and funding capitalized interest on the bond, setting forth the details of said sale and providing for the giving of notice thereof. Final reading.
Mr. City Manager.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. I'd like to ask Mr. White to provide information and answer any questions on this item.
Mr. Mayor, members of the council, as part of the budget that was just adopted, there's an item in there to smooth out the cost of our retirement reserve contributions using debt financing. In order to accomplish that, this ordinance will give us the authority to do so. There's no specific statutory authority in Kansas to execute a transaction like that. Kansas cities have home rules, so this effectively gives ourselves the ability to issue that debt through our own home rule powers.
So this is a home rule ordinance.
And this is not the approval of the bonds at this point. This is simply giving us the authority under which that the council would be considering the approval of the bonds at a later date.
This will give us this is what we do in order to initiate a process so that we can take action later. Is there any discussion or questions? I'm sorry, Ms. Hiller.
I have 2, if I may. The first is that the discussion, and people know I had reservations about it, but I opted to pass on that. But the discussion was $5 million, and this ordinance proposes $7.5 million. Can you explain the difference?
Mr. Mayor, we intend to come back with a proposal to issue $5 million. This would give us the authority to do additional issuance in the future should we desire, without having to readopt the home rule ordinance. I don't have any particular heartburn at one number or the other. This may save a procedural step in the future, however.
But that amount isn't in this particular ordinance. The amount isn't.
The ceiling. It is. It's a ceiling. And we would not anticipate asking this body to come anywhere close to that ceiling with the action at this time.
Give a second question.
Well, just something to share. I learned it in terms of doing a little more research about the whole issue of whether of this process of borrowing the money to level, and it turned out that we really didn't need to do it to protect our bond rating. So I just wanted to share that with folks. And I'm going to still vote against it because I don't want us to borrow, but I understand the preferences of the council. Thank you.
Okay. Other questions? Mr. White?
the two purposes really for the financing are to reduce the outlay from the general fund in fiscal 14 for contributions to that fund, and to bolster the balances in that fund in the event that retirements that occur at a faster pace than what we budgeted for.
Okay, and again, this item allows or provides the opportunity for us to take action. It is not taking the actual action.
Correct.
Any other discussion?
Although the savings is included in the budget that was just announced.
All right, thank you. That's a good point. This is included, savings are in the budget. Any other discussion? All those in favor, vote yes. Opposed, vote no. I vote yes. Thank you. Okay, we need a motion to vote. Could someone move to approve, or what is your pleasure? Okay, it's been moved by Mrs. Ortiz. Is there a second? Second by Mrs. Everhart. Any discussion? Mr. Campos?
I do have to echo the reservations of Councilwoman Hiller. You know, continually adding on to our debt to essentially smooth us over can get very toxic very quickly. And if we look at how much we have debt right now, I don't have that sheet in front of me. We're in the $200 million range right now. So if we could do it by cash, we should do it by cash. So I'll be voting no.
Okay. Any other discussion? Mr. Man Speaker?
If we could clear the board.
Clear the board. Thank you. Those in favor, vote yes. Opposed, vote no. I vote yes. Having voted yes, the home rule ordinance is passed. Item D, ordinance on 2014 property taxes.
D is an ordinance introduced by City Manager Jim Coulson attesting to budgeting property tax revenues for budget year 2014, final reading.
Mr. Coulson.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. Mr. White.
Mr. Mayor, Kansas law requires us to take action to notify the public that the amount of property taxes we're collecting for the next budget year are higher than they were this budget year. That's the purpose of this action.
Okay, this is a pro forma, in a sense, that we have to do as a part of adopting the budget. What is your pleasure? Mrs. Ortiz moves to approve. Mr. Schmidt seconds. Discussion. All those in favor, vote yes. Those opposed, vote no. I vote yes.
We have eight voting yes, Compost and Schwartz voting no.
Eight having voted yes, the ordinance is adopted. Item 6A, applications.
There are none.
I don't believe there are any applications. Go to item 7 is first reading.
A is an ordinance introduced by City Manager Jim Coulson amending City of Topeka Code Section 1830.010, 1835.010, 1835.040, and 1835.220, and specifically repealing said original sections, all concerning the administrative minor plat approval process. First reading.
Thank you. Presentations, Mr. City Manager.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. I want to commend this body. We talked several months ago about the concept of civility and working as a team, and I think even though this was a very challenging budget session and we all had pressures on us that we needed to deal with, I sat here and watched a bunch of people have a lot of conversation with a tremendous amount of stability and professionalism. I'm proud to be part of this body, and I thank you for the great work, and I'm looking forward to us proceeding and going forward. Thank you.
Thank you. You know, a budget meeting is always perhaps one of the most difficult or challenging of the year, and echoing what has just been said. But I also suggest to the council members that while this is fresh in your mind, make some notes or thoughts on what you see, how we can do it better, improve the process. Maybe take a couple days before you do that, but think about it. How can we make the process better than what it is? Clear back, we started this, I don't know, in early July, I guess July the 4th weekend, we had our first budget hearing. budget committee meeting, and by down to August the 20th. So what could we have done differently than we did? I think it's so important to engage everyone, and I want to certainly acknowledge those of you who played major roles tonight in helping us to bring this to closure, so that we could have an adopted budget. Oh, we start. I'm sorry. Who the invocation person?
Oh,
Mrs.
Okay.
Schwartz.
Thank you. I would like to echo that. I think it was very civil, and I think we got through a lot of hours, but I want to also suggest that we do involve more citizen input. I had a town hall meeting last week. There were about 40 people there. Chad was there. I really appreciated him being there. But I think this is one thing that we need to do more, is to involve the citizens. And I'm going to have a coffee and commentary, and Councilman Hiller has agreed to be part of that. If we can do that around town more and get the citizens involved in telling us what they would like to see done, and maybe even at one point having a citizen agenda item on our council agenda. Thank you.
Thank you. Mr. Schmidt? Mr. Harmon?
Thank you, Your Honor. I just have some general comments that have been percolating in my mind since we began this budget process, including the action we've taken tonight. Since 2007, the growth in the city's assessed valuation is a negative 4.5%. Yet the growth in total general fund spending from fiscal year 2011 through fiscal year 2014 has increased by $16 million. By the action tonight, we have increased the mill levy 20% since 2012. That is unprecedented. For every $1 we spend from the general fund, 73 cents is spent on police and fire. With a stagnant property tax base and yearly increases in general fund spending, primarily driven by expenditures for police and fire services, property taxpayers of Topeka can no longer afford to pay for a general fund budget that is primarily driven by public safety costs and expenses. The cost of providing municipal services, primarily public safety, under the existing local government paradigm is unsustainable. It is time that we consider one of the following courses of action, or a hybrid of them. Number one, expand the number of property tax-paying units to broaden the tax-paying base. Number two, restructure and reorganize public safety departments to bring the cost of those departments back in line with what property taxpayers can reasonably be expected to support. Number three, evaluate whether to create a combined or consolidated law enforcement organization countywide. Number four, evaluate whether the fire department's practice of responding to all medical calls is an appropriate utilization of limited and precious resources. Five, evaluate whether the fire department could provide ambulance services countywide. I would ask the mayor, the city manager, and my colleagues on the council to support the time and efforts to fully explore these endeavors. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Harmon. Mrs. Hiller.
Thank you so much, Councilman Harmon, for your comments. I do think I want to thank the staff, all the staff that's here and all the way down the line, our consultants, Dwight, Ari, and the citizens for all the input that we got. We got a lot and a lot of help. But I do think there are takeaways besides this budget, such as what Councilman Harmon said. We need to really look at police and fire, the compression issues, planning issues. There are a lot of takeaways. So I'm hopeful that, as the mayor said, that we've all kind of taken some notes. I'm looking forward to the restructure of our meetings, where we will have more work session time so that we can begin to calendar these items and really work on them, so that we are, not that everyone didn't prepare this year, but I think there's a lot more preparation we can do between now and February, let's say the end of February, so that as much as possible, we've worked with staff to examine these issues
and prepared before the budget cycle even starts so that staff can react. Thank you.
Thank you.
And thanks, everybody.
Mr. Campos.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. I, too, want to echo what Councilman Harmon and Councilwoman Hiller have said. We do have to take some in-depth looks at how we spend our money, how we effectively or not use it. It's important that we have input from our citizens because they're ultimately the ones who are paying that tab. And we have reached a point of critical mass where it's no longer equitable for us to really provide the services at the extent that we are currently provide them and expect that trajectory to continue. So with that, I do thank this body. It's been an honor to work with all of you and listen to your insight and your knowledge and the experience that you bring forth to this budgetary process. It has been very enlightening to see how this works, and I can't thank you enough. Thank you.
Thank you. Mrs. Ortiz.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. I want to thank staff and city manager, but I want to thank my colleagues for being respectful. At the end of the day, that's important to me. Doesn't matter who's chairing, but, you know, just to be respectful, and I appreciate that because we all have things that we're compassionate about. I know at work they were teasing me. They were counting how many times I was cutting Councilwoman Hiller off, and they kind of made a joke of it. And it's no disrespect to her. It's just it's very important to me that when you have the floor that you address the chair and that you have the floor. So, again, I just want to thank you for that, for being respectful. And I hope we can continue to do that. Thank you, Mr. Mayor.
Deputy Mayor, that means that we're not newbies anymore, huh? just I think that it's overall just an echo of what everybody has said here. To be really honest, of course, everybody knows that you hear about the budget meetings, and when you come over here as a new council person, you are very concerned because you don't know how it's going to turn. Like Deputy Mayor said, I think all of us are very passionate about a lot of things, but I think that what prevailed tonight is that we are all passionate about the betterment of our city overall. And that rather than thinking about getting what we wanted within the budget, we really wanted to make sure that our city had everything it needs so that it could start moving forward. I really appreciate the comments that Councilman Harmon had to say at the end. I'm one of those people that is a huge proponent of looking into first responders, maybe doing the services that you suggested, because I think that would be a revenue maker in the long run. But I just think that with the new structure of the meetings, we're going to start seeing a lot more of these discussions happen. So just thank you to everybody.
Thank you. Mr. Man Speaker, close.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. I would like to echo Mr. Harmon's thoughts. I think that one of the issues that this city has dealt with for a significant period of time is that we have stagnated in our population growth. And because our revenues are not increasing based solely on that number, I mean, you're looking at a population that has been almost static for about 4 years. So I would encourage my colleagues over the next year, I mean, it's great to think about the budget and figure out what we can do to fix and what we can do to change, but as leaders in this community, we have the opportunity to expand our tax base by making bold decisions and doing things that restructure the direction for which we're heading, and they have absolutely nothing to do with the budget. But they have everything to do with our day-to-day operation and how we handle ourselves as a city and how we market ourselves to the rest of the world. So I would encourage my colleagues to let's get creative over the next 12 months and come up with ways that we can expand our revenue base so that at the end of the day, it's not a matter of increasing the mill levy because we generated more revenue.
Good, very good. Well, many, many good comments, good thoughts. In public comment, we have two persons signed to speak. The first is Frances Anthony Gary. I do not see her. The second is Isis Gary. I do not see her. Well, that then concludes our meeting. We are adjourned.